Stalin's statues are no longer here. The great airbrusher was himself airbrushed within a few years of his death. Khrushchev's denunciation of Stalin in 1956 was presaged just over a year earlier by his denunciation of ornamentalism. A sign of how much buildings were regarded as an expression of Stalin's will, of how much appearances mattered, and of how much Stalin's disappearance mattered to Khrushchev. But Stalin's metro, his buildings, and his 1935 arterial road plan are inescapable, and they're wonderfully contaminated, gleefully compromised. Stalin had no more idea than anyone else what a socialist city might be. Engels' equation of urbanism and capitalism was often wrong. In Moscow, however, it was predictively right. Stalin's Moscow was a stage waiting for the anarchy of capitalism to happen. There is nowhere in the world a greater Asiatic bazaar hoping to be taken for a European one. Trotsky, too, was wrong when he wrote of the proletariat's congenital incapacity to become a ruling class. Throughout the world, the proletariat has done just that, through consumerism. The proletariat rules us all. Its populist taste is universal law. Stalin may have turned a country into a council estate littered with death camps and monuments to his tyranny, but he's increasingly celebrated. The sentimental longing for the days of his leadership is shared over generations and social classes. The tiny minority of Germans who express a similar respect for Hitler in this way are subjects of obloquy.
Стали думать, что это удающий человек, который со временем пройдет, и когда будет ставить ему памятники по всей стране. Хотя их сносили, а их поставят. Но я чувствую, если у нас был бы сегодня такой руководитель государства, мы сегодня бы жили намного лучше. У нас было бы единое государство, которое было Советский Союз.
Революция!
Dispossessed and the ideologically right on, march under red flags waving pictures of Chairman Joe. They apparently yearn for an era when comradely enamel medals were awarded for superfertility and reaping feats, for digging and forging and grassing up your fellows. To live under the Soviets was to be at school forever.
Наша родина, Советский Союз. Я люблю ее и этим горжусь. За доллары не продаюсь. Советская милиция меня бережет. А что сейчас делается? Рвут на части родину мою, уничтожают наповал.
They exhibit a dissent which their hero would never have tolerated, but which the later liberal czars did, to their posthumous regret, no doubt. Had their secret police been as single-minded as the Cheka and the NKVD, Djugashvili would not have lived long enough to become Stalin, Ulyanov to become Lenin, Bronstein to become Trotsky. Never trust three pseudonymous moustaches.
Сталину просто вначале как религия, с детства, я родом из детства, как и все мы, вот, я вначале верил как религия. Потом я учился, работал и стал замначальником лаборатории, и у меня шло от религии к сознательному пониманию Сталина, роли Сталина. Это величайший, честнейший рыцарь 20 века, это честнейший человек в мире.
Communism is now a choice, which probably means that it isn't communism. Just as marching in honor of Stalin is not taboo, neither is building in his image. Again, 60 years on, no German would contemplate mimicking Hitler's grandest style. But Joe building is everywhere in Moscow. The architecture of purges, terror, and genocide is stripped of its associations. It's just another style choice, served up in a spirit of willed forgetfulness. But these buildings leave us in no doubt about the kind of architecture that betokens both the last truly powerful caste in Russia and the last proud moment in Russian history, the victory in the Great Patriotic War 6 decades ago, that often feels as if it was 6 weeks ago. Of all the buildings made in Russia since the Soviets' demise, none is so symbolically loaded and aesthetically questionable as the Cathedral of Christ the Saviour. This is a precisely detailed reconstruction of the cathedral which stood on this site and which was demolished to make way for the unbuilt Palace of the Soviets. It's an immutable law of mankind that when one religion dies, those with an appetite for credulousness will seek out another. Let's turn back the clock to a never time and a neverland where nothing changes, to the illusory solaces of stasis, to the illusory solaces of an older superstition, which will, in the cyclical way of things, itself eventually be succeeded by a second coming. Thank you.